All right, everybody, this is Big Buster coming at you, the original Razorback. You understand what I'm saying? And you're watching Buster, H.R. Johnson on YouTube. And this right here is the most important part of all. Like, share, and subscribe. If not, I'll come out there and kick your teeth down your stinking throat.
To another great hour of XOW Wrestling, the new generation in professional wrestling. I'm Kimball Winstead, sitting along ringside with my partner, David Burcham, who is... I'm sorry I wasn't here for the last 2 weeks, but I've had to see a chiropractor with bad back troubles from having to carry you the last time I was on the show. Okay, well anyway, ladies and gentlemen, a lot of things going on here in the XOW. I mean, the past several weeks, it's been hot, it's been exciting. We've had the IWF invasion. These guys come in here running roughshod over everybody, David. They sure have. They've been showing who's the boss. And I envy you for being the IWF announcer, because you are still under contract with IWF.
No. Nothing can be further from the truth. Not under contract with those guys anymore. That's in the past. But the XOW guys, they've had enough. They're not going to stand for it anymore. Here last week, you heard it, no more. So it ought to be hot and heavy tonight. Also, Hollywood Jimmy, your friend, he's been suspended by the XOW Commission for Action. Yeah, that's right. He indefinitely suspended from the XOW, not here indefinitely. So that's under investigation also.
It should be under investigation. That's the way XOW treats their guys. They suspend them for doing absolutely nothing just because Polly Knight's got a little haircut. In fact, here representing the Hollywood Clique, I'm going to bring him out right now. He is a legend. He is a superstar among superstars. He is the one and only Brutus Brown. And with Brick House, representing the Hollywood Clique, we have Tony Watts, the greatest referee ever to put on a striped shirt. We have the light heavyweight champion, Colton Anderson. Brick House, what is the deal with Hollywood Jimmy and Death Wish being suspended?
First of all, let me give a shout out to my man, Hollywood Jimmy. Keep your head up, brother. Things are gonna go right on. Now, first of all, Hollywood Jimmy is CEO and president of the most finest, devastating professional organization. You know what? Good help is so hard to find. You did that on purpose. If you do that again, I'm gonna drop you on your freaking head. First of all, let me just say this right now. Just because Hollywood Jimmy is not here tonight, just because Death Wish is not here tonight, just because Lord Humongous is not here tonight, we are here. And we will roll on and we will devastate anybody that get in the ring with us. We ain't gonna lose no stuff tonight just because the CEO and the president of the most devastating professional wrestling organization is not here tonight. But justice will prevail. Hollywood Jimmy will be back. And brother, you better tell them what time it is, because we ain't gonna miss no step. As a matter of fact, it done upset us because of what happened with Hollywood Jimmy Blaylock. And when we get upset, we do things and very nasty things to people. And right now tonight, we gonna take our frustration out on somebody. Oh yeah, so you're the reason, oh, you proud of that fact, huh? Well, you know what? I don't discriminate against old people. I'll drop you on your head too, sucker. You doubt it. What you gonna do if I do? What can you do? You know what? Some people get behind the power of the pen and they let it go to their head. Let me tell you something right now, man. Let me tell you something right now. A message from Hollywood Jimmy Blaylock to me. You think you might have won. You think you might have won up somebody by suspending Hollywood Jimmy Blaylock. But what you done did is just ticked us off and made us mad. And now we're going to unleash the full fury of the Hollywood Clique. And you'll see tonight, it's your fault what happened to Pete Rose tonight when he get in the ring with me. I'm going to do some nasty things at that point, and it's all going to be because of you.
All right, that match is coming up. Pete Rose against Brick House Brown. I guess you heard that, didn't you? What you gonna do about it?
Nothing.
I guess Brickhouse Brown's spoken out here throwing threats at the XOW commissioner. I don't know if he knows, but that's why Hollywood Jimmy's in the position he's in right now.
Listen, the Hollywood Clique do not threaten. They don't promise. What they say is just plain fact.
Well, from there, let's go to the ring for the next, well, for the first great match in this show. Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, this is Happy.
Therefore, he didn't break the rule. He
stretched it. Let me just say that. Right now,
he's trying to stretch that record.
Colton Addison just brutalizing Pappy, and this Tony Watts on the apron. And look at this guy.
Oh, boot to the inner thigh. Come on, Winstead.
No, that's a little north of the inner thigh, David.
And now he's right in the inner thigh.
Right now, Colton Addison in control, and Tony Watts on the outside distracting the ref. And I'll tell you what, this guy pointed at the spokesman.
Colton Addison. I know who Pappy is. He's got no bras.
Oh.
Right now, Colton Addison choking away.
Exactly right. We're 5 minutes into the action, and I tell you what, Colton Addison just brutalizes Pappy.
Pappy keeps getting that shoulder blade. God, Colton Anderson, he knows what he's doing. He knows exactly what he's doing. He doesn't get a belt losing the guys like this big fat tub of goo in there right now.
Well, let me just say this right now. Pappy working on the left leg of Colton Anderson.
Good. Yeah, that's a man locking out right there.
The action getting back and forth from this one. Wait a minute. Tommy Knox at ringside. David, Tommy Knox has made his way out.
That's right.
He hung me with this noose.
if I have to beat Ray, or if I have to beat a washed up old wrestler like you, I'll do it. I don't care anymore. I want my revenge on Psycho. If I had to do it tonight, tomorrow night, in a parking lot, if I had to go to the institution where he's at to find him, I'll be there.
Boy, you're beginning to bore the hell out of me.
This guy comes out of the crowd, I know where Justin Reed comes up, back jump. Big Daddy Stormy, he's scared. He got a situation here. Well, let me just say this right now. I would hate to know that I had to deal with these guys.
He said Storm came out here to smoke his mind. Well, exactly.
Well, it didn't last very long because he was back jumped off.
You give me those two punks tonight. This is why you find me. Are you bad enough to do it again? Are you just a little chicken, bad fruit wearing, little pellet tub you want to be?
You keep him back. You keep him back. Keep him back.
Give me the match.
You want the match?
You make the match.
It's done. But you have better control your men.
I understand right, it's done. Tonight? Woo! Is that right, Axeman? Done deal? Well, there it is. Sean Reed and Justin Reed tonight against the Asylum.
Some commissioner you are. Look at you. You suspend your one of the most popular guys in the Hollywood clique. Your other XOW guys are going nuts. That's why IWS is going to take over. You keep that crazy goof away from me.
I don't know about anybody taking over, but we certainly have a situation. You heard it right here tonight, the Asylum against Sean Reed, Justin Reed. I saw that. Thank goodness we were out of the way. Right now, let's go to the ring with the next match in there.
I always knew you were that kind of guy.
I meant watching my back.
Oh, wait a minute now. Watch what you say here.
Listen. Okay, all right.
Referee checking out Ryan, so fine.
Now, the Pink Flamingos have taught me a lot about wrestling. They've taught me the takedowns. They've taught me the in and outs.
Not a good choice of words when there's a flamingo involved. Right now, two guys.
Get your mind out.
Two guys who can really fly around the ring. DC and Ryan, so fine.
Fly around the ring. They can fly over the ring. They can fly under the ring. That's how talented these two guys are. But Ryan, so fine is just a little bit much more talented than DC David Cross.
Don't know about that. These two guys both talented in their own right.
And Ryan getting frustrated.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
His hair's kind of sticking up. Have you seen something about Mary? Anyway. All right. Ryan's so fine.
Circle each other once again. Set to lock up. Call an elbow.
And they locked up again. You know, when I was a manager, I sent several guys against DC, and believe me, I've had my problems with DC in the past. That guy can sneak up on you in a heartbeat. Coming straight at you, if you can believe that.
Once again,
Ryan's on fine, calling Rebel. He's not going to let DC sit. That's why. What's the other rules you got here in XOW?
Why do you keep talking about the IWF?
Because of the Mile High Club. Because Ryan So Fine is the IWF champion.
What does the IWF have to do with anything?
Ryan So Fine and the Mile High Club.
I mean, yeah, so these guys have made it. This is not an IWF sanctioned event. This is the XOW, the new generation in professional wrestling.
Now see, this is where DC's having a problem with Ryan So Fine, and he'll always have a problem with Ryan So Fine. DC's used to find bigger, slower guys, guys who cannot keep up with him. Ryan can keep up with him, plus some.
Well, yeah, to an extent you're right. He has fought a lot of bigger guys, but he's fought a lot of quick, fast guys and wrestling the same style as him. But Ryan So Fine, a crafty ring veteran, and he's not scared to take a short.
Right now, he wouldn't be holding his gut, gasping for air.
David Cross down courtesy of the knee to the midsection, and Ryan So Fine in control.
Listen how he's screaming in pain from Ryan So Fine, driving that knee right into his neck, right into the spinal cord, where the base of the skull meets the spinal cord.
Exactly right, just digging the knee in, Ryan So Fine. David Cross back up. Ryan So Fine in control. Boy, David Cross is in trouble.
And he took him over and down. He planted him in that man.
Ryan backing his man up, looking for Cross. And misses.
Oh, Cross lying down in the middle of the ring.
They both connect and they're down.
And the referee administered the count. Is it three?
See each other. DC backs it in, rips off into the ring. Opposite side of the ring, makes it in, right in his spear. And he'd be in. He speared him right off the desk. That's a two count.
See, it's going to take a lot more than that to keep Ryan so fired down.
Professional wrestling, and I tell you what, this summer is going to be a hot one for the XOW. When we come your way, come check these guys out. It's going to be a long, hot summer. Ryan brings his mask on, nails him with a big clothesline, and he's dying. DC in a bad way. Ryan just stalking his man, picks him up to a vertical base, nails him,
and now Ryan. He's not the XOW champion, he's the IWF champion. If Ryan So Fine had been pushing on him like that, Ryan wouldn't have had to knock his teeth out.
I think we got a lover's quarrel.
Ain't that the truth? Can't see it making all better.
And it's a shame because it's only one of the three teeth he had left, I'm telling you.
Man, Ryan, what a situation here.
This is just a little disagreement, just a little disagreement.
Ryan So Fine, here we go. Kids in attendance and kids watching tonight on television.
It touches your heart.
Well, he touched him somewhere.
Shut up!
He's
trying to calm him down!
Come on. All right, ladies and gentlemen. It's that time again. Unfortunately, we have to give these guys their airtime. So if we could, like to call out the...
Is for the last 3 years all we've heard is please.
was too drunk to even call the matches for IWF. That's why Mr. Sensational got rid of him. Hollywood Jimmy isn't here this week, and I know you people miss him. You people miss the greatest commentator ever walked the face of the planet. Mr. Sensational has promised that he'll be here soon enough. He's taking care of the business because, baby, IWF is fixing to take over. So you bunch of idiots better jump on the bandwagon while you have the opportunity, or else you'll be just like XOW. You'll be left behind.
The only thing, this, hey, you shut up, fat man. I ain't changed that much. I was still slapping the face clean out of your fat mouth. Next week, we're gonna give the IWF a little taste of that slapping, fat boy.
Once again, it's an example of our esteemed commissioner, fat man in a little coat, letting his XOW misfits run wild. And you should be ashamed of yourself, especially being an IWF commentator, still under contract, I might add.
Not an IWF commentator. That's in the past, David. I don't know how many times I have to say that tonight. Right now, got great singles action. Let's go to the ring. Let's get it under way.
Ringside to kind of keep an eye on things, and I'll tell you what, personally, I'm glad to see you. Let me just say this. Whatever happened between the Hawk Brothers and the Hollywood Clique, it was for the better of the Hawk Brothers. I promise you that. I promise you that. Right now, Brickhouse Brown in control. Just stomping away on the Big House of Pain in there. What's the delight of Tony Watson on the outside?
Yeah, I hope X-Man, I hope Big Brody Hawk, I hope all these people are watching. There's only one house in XOW, and it's made of brick.
Well, let me just say this right now. The Brickhouse is in control with a reverse chinlock on the Big House of Pain. The referee checking out to make sure it doesn't slip down into a chokehold.
X-Man, I don't know what you're going to do about Brody Hawk.
Of rejects because they don't have class like Brickhouse and Tony Watts and the Hollywood Clique. Well, right now, Brickhouse in control on the Big House of Pain. He's down on the floor and look at him. Look at that guy's a snake in the grass. He's a piece of trash just like Hollywood Jimmy Blaylock. But somebody's going to get their hands on Tony Watts. And when it happens, I just want to say I hope like the victims are getting good.
What happened? I had to take my glasses off.
Blacks handle up the red apron on the House of Pain. Exactly right. Right out here in front of the broadcast position. Oh, man. Big chop and House of Pain just reeling.
And he's done some spring cleaning on that house. I'll tell you what.
Well, he's definitely in control of the Brick House is. Right now, Tony Watts with the referee in there.
Oh, come on. Going right in the camera.
Look at Tony Watts. Somebody, Tony Watts needs to get his tail out of the ring.
Right in the camera.
I mean, the referee has a job to do, and right now, right out here in front of the broadcast position.
He wasn't pointing back to them. The commissioner's holding me back, I take care of
it. Well, I believe that. Brody Hawk saying the commissioner holding him back, making sure that he does not get involved in the action.
Like you would have done the same thing.
Hey, look at this. And Tony Watts with a little added leverage over here, just grabbing the hand of Brickhouse Brown, helping him administer pain to the House of Pain. And look, here he goes again. The referee out of position.
Good sportsmanship between Brickhouse and Tony Watts. Shaking hands on.
Good job, well done.
Tony's pulling on him, giving him a little leverage in there.
Oh, no, they're just congratulating.
And there we go.
Brickhouse congratulating Tony Watts for his position right now as a villain for Hollywood Jimmy.
Right, guys.
And Brickhouse driving a knee right into the face of House of Pain.
I want some.
And Brickhouse,
he is telling Brody Hawk.
He is calling out Brody Hawk over here sitting by me right now.
Brody Hawk just begging the commissioner to let him go in there, but nothing doing. This is a signed match, a grudge match between these two guys.
I'm telling you, I don't want to be used for anything. You got the IWF breathing down one side of your neck. You got the Hollywood breathing down the other side of your neck. You are not coming to
do it. Variation of the title clutch on the market.
Stuck in the middle with you.
Because he is Brickhouse Brown.
was pushing Brickhouse off the top and House of Pain back up. Big
brother, let me tell you something, you little bobblehead doll. Best thing you better do when it comes to the House of Pain is shut your mouth and sit on that fat butt and keep stuffing burgers in your mouth. Yeah, Brickhouse, I'm the sucker, right? Hollywood Jimmy wasn't here this week, and Tony, you couldn't get the job done, boy. So let me tell you something. Next week, when you're sitting at home and your mind is racing and your fears are rising, you'll realize you just stepped into the House of Pain. Testify!
Third revenge. Score one for the XOW.
Yeah, but who counts as XOW?
Idiot.
They're supposed to be, that's
he's running. You know what I'm talking about, Tony Watts. So, who knows what he is. But right now, let's go to the ring. We've got Grudge Tag Team action.
Right into Justin Reed.
Oh,
the side of the face.
And they're not letting the man get out of the corner. Now see, that's why the eyes are.
Let me say this, they're the XOW Tag Team Champions. They're the best that the XOW has to offer. So, yes.
And yes. That's exactly my point. These two idiots and their stupid manager, Storm, they don't even know that they're tag team champions. They don't even know that they're tag team champions. These are just two shiny. These are just two shiny pieces of metal. That's all he cares about is Katie over there.
Exactly right. The Warrior right now working on
in a sick place. That'll shake your sacrum. You know what the sacrum are? Those are the five fused vertebrae at the end of the base of the spine. The rock.
Yeah.
the goings on and watching the asylum. Because like I said, the warning was handed down right here under the lights. So now see, here is where the match is turning to the favorite popular. Psycho and Wraith, they're maniacs, they're brawlers. Justin and Sean Reed, they're wrestlers. They have got Psycho down on the mat. They're keeping that leg tied up, keeping him off his vertical base, because it doesn't matter how big you are, once you're down on the mat, you're all the same size.
Exactly right. Sean Reed comes in, nice play, stomp, and his break comes in, returns a favor. Stomps on Justin Reed, and Justin beats Psycho up to his feet, and takes him right over to his corner where they can, where the Sean Reed and Justin Reed can work on Psycho over there, and they really cut the ring off. Now, Captain Big Man is probably the main.
I bet you didn't think Popular. I bet you didn't think Popular wrestling was going to get to the side of the
team. Well, I'll be honest with you, these guys surprised me. They really
come to the nation as a tactic.
No, I've seen them before. Oh, these guys, they have a game plan, and they're working it. And I've got to take my hat off to them. They made a plan, and they're working the plan. Great hand to kind of break things up. Referee makes him get back out to his corner.
Well, now, wait a minute. That's a stupid question, because he never been popular.
Right now, Sean Reed. Oh, man, he was booted by Psycho.
Almost with a neck breaker as he went for the reverse DDT.
We're 10 minutes into the action, and man, let me just tell you, these guys, they've been fighting tooth and nail, and I've said it a minute ago, gotta take my hat off to Popular. They're hanging in there with these guys, but right now, Sean Reed in a bad way. Warrior Justin over Justin, break him off, get that goof off of him. Wraith into the ring right now, just throwing haymakers.
Those guys, hey, the House of Pain made his return this week.
measure of revenge on Rick Ice Brown. No Hollywood Jimmy. The world's a better place. No death wish. Well, let me say this. Next week promises to be another great week. So, for David Burcham, I'm Kimball Winstead. We'll see you right here next week.